Hello everyone, it is Pughy here doing another video for my YouTube, and once again I'm not actually doing a replay today, or for this video at least. I'm actually doing a tutorial, and this is going to be a PVT opening tutorial. So we're going to look at Protoss v Terran and from the Protoss side, and look at an opening that you can do in Heart of the Swarm against the Terrans. And of course, we all hate Terrans, so this is especially good for most of us. So this is a build that this is my own build. Like, I haven't taken this from anyone. I've seen people discuss builds, and that's what led to it. Up until like a week ago, well, say 2 weeks ago, I was doing the exact same build with two gas geysers instead of one. And of course, there is a very interesting trick that a lot of people are doing to get out faster tech these days in Heart of the Swarm, and there is a specific thing that a lot of people might think you're absolutely nuts for not getting, but that is what's going on. So I'm going to jump into the replay. It's a very standard little pressure opening with an expansion, just a little bit later than the Terrans, but about standard for a one gate expansion, or just a little bit later than one gate. So jump into the game. First off, I always 9 scout, because I don't trust Terrans, and I want to make sure that if there is a gas that I see it. Alright, that is very imperative to me. So I see the gas and I get out. Alright, so because of that, there's a little like, if you go for a 9 scout, you can't go for a 13 gateway with the double chrono on your Nexus before the gateway, right? So I go for a 14 gateway, so I can afford the double chrono, and you know, have constant probe production. Then it's followed by a 15 gas with 3 guys on gas, and you know, 18 core, 16 pylon, all the good jazz you expect, and then of course a 19 zealot. All right, so 19 zealot, still only one gas. This probe still doing his job. Don't want to lose it, because you know, why would you? It shouldn't die to anything unless you, you know, scout a bit later and it gets locked into the base. That's the only time it should really die. And of course, I did see the gas of my opponent, so I'm a bit wary of some sort of tech play incoming. And I have 4 replays as well. So I'm going to go through all of them. And you know, sometimes personal preference does come into it. I seen the gas and I was a bit ooh, so I get my extra gas, right, just to play it more safe, because I, you know, I want to guarantee good times. So the secret to this build is, of course, you don't get your warp gate. That is the secret. You just don't get your warp gate, and it's a bit late, but you spend the extra gas on your mothership core. Alright, so it kind of goes 19 core, 22 pylon, 24 stalker, 26 pylon, 27 mothership core roughly, or 29 ish and then your second pylon. So it was a 27 mother core, it went up to 29, and then of course 31 with the Stalker that was just produced, and I expand with it. The expansion will be going up fairly soon. You don't have to worry about any type of proxy pylons, because you don't build anything on the map, and of course there is no warp gate anyway, so you don't have to worry about that. And then of course you just grab all your units, which is a Zealot, 2 Stalkers, and your mothership core, and you run across the map. And what's this? Oh. No way. he is talking about, he's a British player that's a friend. He's really cool. And we're in the same division, and we're always in the same division somehow. And I'm ahead of him, so he's a little annoyed. But yeah, okay. So here's the build going. Of course, all the units don't come in one go, so we have to wait for them. Stalker gets your first Zealot, mothership core, because it goes across the map like so, and then the last Stalker. And of course, you just want to kill a couple of units and get scout off. That's it. Alright, and you have to be careful, of course, because you are running across the map with units. And as we can see, there is a medevac with Widow Mines in production, so there's this X amount of time to get home and defend. Alright, so the Marines come out a bit faster than I expected. So I pull the Zealot back, obviously. The Mothership Core then gets targeted, because it's obviously a very nice item to snipe. And the 2 Stalkers get to pick away at those Marines, and I force my opponent back into his base. which of course gives me the 100% map dominance that I would like. And this allows me to get scout. I saw the medevac, I believe. I'm pretty sure I did. And yeah, I saw the building, because of course the mothership core has really good vision. So what? Actually, I didn't see it, but you pretty much figure it out, because that's what happens. So there's no expansion. Run home as soon as the pressure is over, right? And of course you keep units close to here. You have to be very careful, of course, because you have no photo, no overcharge, and you have to get your robo, alright? So these are ways that you can play it out. I'm not going to go nuts and talk about all these build orders, but you pretty much, as soon as the robo, your nexus is down, you take your gas. If you don't have it, then you just throw down a robo, because you have to prepare for these type of attacks. And, you know, I react fairly fast enough so I don't lose anything major. I lose one probe. Not bad at all. And I already have my observer just in the nick of time, right? That is such close timing that it's pretty awesome, actually. So that flies back, and yeah, I'm only going up to 10 minutes in the games. That way we have a solid point that we, you know, we can see what goes on. So the expansion for my opponent is, of course, being done now. It is in base to protect them. I go for a forge because I like to have cannons to protect against widow mines, and I haven't scouted all that much so far. I have a nice scout there. No, that was my probe that died then, and I have a probe by here. Of course, you pretty much, when you see this, you expect a lot of drops, so you just build pylons everywhere, so you, like, they can't get you without them, you know, being spotted, and then that just ends it all. So, you know, he comes here, I have my units waiting, I have my mothership core, etc, etc. And my observer also just passed that banshee, so I know what's coming from there. And, you know, nice just defensive posture, and I have a cannon in each mineral line. And I think I have an extra one by here, because I just want to protect my natural, you know, helium run by, stuff like that. I need to get the banshee. I have perfect vision, I have an observer, so I don't have to worry about anything tricky. And yeah, that's how it goes. From this point I will follow it up with Colossus. I take my extra gases and, you know, all that good jazz. And you know, I have a really nice harvester lead over my opponent, you know, 10 minutes and all that. So, you know, this is a pressure build. This isn't the most greediest build you'll ever get. You know, my opponent pressured, it stays even, it's cool. So that is game number one. And of course this is, you know, Harvest Swarm isn't even out yet, so all these builds are within reason and, you know, all that stuff. So new kick 30. We'll go for this one, it's shortest. Of course, the build I'm going for is it's limited by map as well. So far, the only maps you can really use in Heart of the Swarm are Star Station, Corehole City, Newkirk City, Howland Peak, and what's that one? Oh, Cloud Kingdom. And that's of course because you have to you abuse certain parts of the map. Like, it's not very good on Daybreak, for example, because you can't really too much. You can't get to the wall, or you'll understand when you see where it works. Like on this map, for example, obviously they expand, the bunker goes by there. You can't do anything to the bunker, but the mothership core can come in, have a nice little scout. If any units come to the edge, you can pick them off, and you can also drop a time warp, which, you know, does affect your opponent's economy just a little bit. So once again, 9 scout incoming for me. There's that. Do some harassment. I always harass like a madman, because why not? And this is another thing. Of course, when you fly in with your mothership core, there is time to deal damage. So on this map, because it's quite close to, you know, being safe, harass, and then, you know, you can target those SCVs later when the mothership core flies in for some guaranteed kills. So that's what's going on. Back up to here, you know, 14 gateway, 18 cyber core, 1 gas this time, because I see no gas out of my opponent, so I'm like, okay, I can, you know, I'm safe. And like we said, you know, everything standard, sub core finishes, then it's like a 24 stalker. My Zealot is out on the map, because of course you won the Zealot to guarantee it if any marines come out, that, you know, you don't have to micro away, you have to, You know, the Zealot will force them back, and the Mothership cores slow so that the Mothership doesn't get sniped, whereas it will if there's just Stalkers, and of course Stalkers are expensive, so you'd rather lose the Zealot, and in case there is an eBay block, which is, once again, very popular. So, no Warp Gates. I Chrono Boost like a madman. I like Chrono Boost in my Nexus. Stalker in production, Chrono Boost the Mothership core, because of course it does build up energy as well. The Terran is scouting, building his expansion, etc, etc, and my expansion is about to go up. And as you can see, the time is fairly reasonable. It's 4 minutes and 45 seconds. That's not so bad, you know, that's 60 seconds after the Terrans. And that's relatively close to what it would be without this type of build. Of course, I do build it before the Stalker sometimes. Like this game I did, some games I don't. Like, no build is perfect, so this example, I built the Nexus first, which is actually fine, because the Stalker, you can Chrono Boost it, and they're fast, and the Mothership core is really slow, so it will get there in time. So, you know, we're up to 34 supply now. This is when I pretty much stopped writing my build orders. This is when you take your second gas, you start, obviously, your Warp Gate, you can either go for a Sentry or a Robo. This is personal preference. Sometimes my gas is a bit starved, because I didn't get this straight away. So I take that gas, I build, I think it's a robo first. It's a robo. And of course down here I am seeing what's going on. So this is what I was saying, like, you know, they come out, they want to do some pressure. The Zealot stops your Mothership dying, that's really important. I should be building stuff behind this. I'm a bit distracted by, you know, this is a bit APM intensive. And of course, you know, like I said, I fly in, see what's going on, and I drop the time warp, which is very nice indeed. Like I said, you know, the Marines can't really come that close. Get some kills, why not, if the you know, the Mothership core gives you vision. There's my robo. Of course, I didn't have to rush for the robo really, because I didn't see gas, so I know there's not super fast widow mines, and I seen the expansion, so it's not so bad. And like, I come back in again and just drop a time warp. That's two time warps, why not? You know, I throw my opponent off his build already, thanks, as you can tell with this. And you know, I'm keeping him on his side of the map. My harvest account isn't as good as it should be. Like, I'm a bit distracted, and I'm not chronoing as much, and you know, sometimes it's like the first game of the day, so it's not going to be the, you know, godlike code-esque skill that you would expect from myself. And you know, spill a lot of stuff, get your gateways, get your robo tech, and you know, I got good gas income. I should really be chronoing my probes a lot more. That's very disappointing on me. And so let's see what happens here. We have this big ball of Marines. I kind of scared my opponent, so he didn't really tech at the beginning of the game, which means his Marines just come out. And does that just force fill them out? Of course, you have the photon overcharge if you need it to defend you against a lot of Marines. And, you know, force fields keep him back. And then, of course, once my Colossus are out, no worries at all. Supply is relatively close, and that is 11 minutes into the game. So, let's leave this bad boy. Come on. Multiplayer. So, we just done that one. Let's do the Star Station. So, this, in my opinion, is probably the best map for this type of build. Definitely the best map, in my opinion, because the ramp to the natural to the main is like where you attack from near enough. You can force field it from, you know, outside. So there's that. Obviously you can come right back here with your Mothership core, your Stalkers, and just peg away, which is very nice indeed. So we'll speed up a little bit because we don't want to slow. And like I was saying, if you see two gas, then you can a gas out of the Terran player, then you can get two gas yourself, delay your expansion a little bit, make sure you know, to scout what's going on. If it's most of the time on this map, or Core Hall City for example, it's just going to be a Reaper, so they will expand. And of course, if you spend too long not expanding, you will fall behind, so you have to be very careful. So 9 scout, 14 gateway, double corona boost. There's the gateway. Gas 15, pylon 16. It's like an 18 cybernetic score. 19 zealot. See, there's that, 19 zealot. Get ready. There's that. And then, you know, 24 stalker. Got a scout. I've scouted him, I believe. What did I scout? Let's see. Alright, I've seen the expansion. That's all I needed to know. That's a really big deal. He's not going to have an expansion that early with a gas taken. So I know it's just a gasless expansion. It's no problem at all. Of course, you know, like I said, I'm fairly good player. I'm Season 1 Masters. I'm a 1300 point Masters at the moment in Heart of the Swarm. And, you know, seeing that at that time just tells me there is no gas. And I, you know, that's just how it goes. Like, I just know that. So it is 30 supply for me. Mothership core now just finishing. The Stalker also in production. Let's check the time on the expansion. Once again, 4:45. And my second Stalker was already in production, so my build order is much better this game compared to the last one on Cloud Kingdom. Immediately we can see that. And of course you need the 32 pylon to carry on building your probes behind it. Second gas now taken. So that is a 34 gas. I'm going to actually write this down as well, because I'll put these in the comments so people kind of have an idea. Well, 32 pylon, 34 gas. Gas. And as we move up, so Stalker, second Stalker doesn't take too long. Like I said, you run straight to this position. You make sure, obviously, the Zealot, like, you attack move here, so make sure the Zealot doesn't run in. If any Marines come out, they're gonna die or just take some damage. There's no way you should lose anything here, really. Because if the mothership, like, if you're forced to run away because there's too many Marines, that's when you sacrifice the Zealot so your mothership core can get away. So the Zealot is the only thing you should be losing behind it. And let me just write that down. I'm, of course, behind this. I haven't gotten... Oh, okay. I'm taking my extra gas and my natural so I can start getting stuff straight away. I should be building my... my robo and my my sentry. Because a lot of people don't get they get early sentries so they can get things like the hallucination to scout, but I scout with this, so I'm okay. It's okay. My expansion, you know, is not really that far behind. My economy is a little bit okay. Could be a few more probes ahead. And look at this, you know, this game I kill that SCV. I kill the tech lab. I kill this little bastard right by you. I didn't mean to swear then, but... And, you know, these Marines, watch this. These Marines come in. So, with some fast reactions, of course, they're always going to target down the mothership core. I drop that. Stalker's been targeted because, of course, that is the ranged unit. And look at that. All the Marines die. I've lost nothing so far. So, I'm in a really damn good spot. Really good spot now. And I have to, of course, be careful of these widow mines. That's the very thing you got to be careful. Of course, if they go to borrow, you just run away. And I think I lose... No, I killed it. So that goes down. That's a gas unit. I'm stopping the the starport being built here. Of course, if it was built like by here, it wouldn't really do anything. And look at that, you know. That could have been a widow mine drop on the way to my base right then. That would have been on the way to my base. Behind this, the first thing you always build is, of course, an observer, forge. I got some good economy. I got a lot of gas because I took my extra gas geyser. I'm still working on this build, alright? But, of course, there's not too much long left of the beta. And, you know, people can take their own this, look at it, and interpret it how they like and, you know, adjust it, of course. So, I've done some really good pressure, and you don't want to spend too much time harassing the opponent. So, I come back. And, you know, I lost a lot of shield, a lot of hull on him, hull on my mothership core, hull on that Zella, but I got a lot of kills. I've lost nothing, I've killed 11 units. That's only 8 minutes into the game, so that's, you know, I think it's only like 2 SCVs as well, but still, that's really big thing. And then of course, you know, I put Pylon over here, just so I love proxy pylons. I love pylons everywhere on the map I possibly can. Rover bay at about 9 minutes. That's what we're going for. That's what I like to go for. Because at the moment, I am supply bucked, so that's bad. Because you really have to be careful. You can't really go high Templars anymore first. Because if they go mech, or you have to scout the pants off them to go mech, to go high Templars. Because otherwise, you just lose. You know, if they push you with tanks and you have high Templars, and it's not going to work out very well. And this is how I also deal with drops. So I'll show you this because it's still relatively early. I see the dropship, thanks to, of course, my observer, which, like, I would consider myself very good with my observer placement. I place them in, you know, good spots. I see a lot of stuff, and I start a cannon, but there, just to protect. I already have one because I don't trust these with Widow Mines. Photon overcharge before it gets there, and I open Stalkers ready. And that was a four Widow Mine drop that didn't drop anything. So, very good, and you know, once again, my lead is even further into the game, and that was only 10 minutes 30. So you can see how I play all these sins and all that. So that is the third game, which of course means we are going on to the last one now. And then after this, I'm going to cast a quick game of the Ogness. I keep calling them the Ogness like it's pint. And this guy was actually a map hacker, and I will show you that, because he was 100% map hacking. So we'll go through the build once again. You know, 9 scout, like a map like Cloud Kingdom, you've got, like, 9 scouts are fantastic. You get there, really good timing, you get to see exactly what goes on. Like, double Chrono Boost before Gateway on 14. There's that. Like I said, gotta harass. If you're really good with your probe, you can really do some good harassment. Sometimes, I think, did I kill him? Oh no, I lose this one. I lose him. So that was bad. Sometimes you get a little desperate, like, oh, it was so close, I'm gonna go back, and that's what sometimes happens. Of course, I saw no gas, so I'm feeling relatively safe. I play the standard, but of course, my supply is one more down because of that probe that died. Oh, yep, I accidentally built my warp gate. Still a higher bit to get out of that. And, you know, everything's looking okay. Everything's a little bit off, but it's acceptable. So let's see. Build orders. Yeah. That comes out. The Nexus is a little bit late, but 10 seconds compared to some of the other games. Still before 5 minutes. You know, this was a really fast CC, so it's later. He hasn't actually got his orbital making yet. That's a bit odd. That was really fast. It's a lot faster than you normally see it. He skipped a couple probes, I bet. But this guy was a cheater, so I'm not surprised that he's pretty crap. What an asshole. I'll show you that he's 100% cheating. There's no way. It's not cheating. So, once again, I'm doing the same thing. And of course, I think he repaired the one that was, you know, 5 health. But I come in, I drop that on the minerals, and I get a couple of kills. If they don't react straight away, you can get nearly 2. Like, this one nearly went down. And like I said, you keep your units close to the edge. So, if the Marines chase it, you will get a Marine or 2. So, I've gotten a pretty fast robo with this. I've gotten my gases. I don't have my sentry being made yet. I think I make it in a second with the Chrono Boost just before my warp gate finishes. And my economy is okay. It's okay. Like, this wasn't the most super awesome executed build ever, so forgive me. And this guy's taking his gases. Look at that. He's nearly on 4 gas with, like, barely any harvesters. That just shows you crappy is. One forge, robo, sentry, and of course, you know, just to play it safe. And the mothership core, you know, that has, you get the mothership core early, so it has the nice energy, so any type of pressure is dealt with the photon overcharge. And yeah, so I have a really good habit of building pylons everywhere. Like, you'll see that in so many games. I just gotta do it, just in case. It's actually like my specialty, is what I'm known for. But a lot of observers as well. So Immortal plus one, Robo Bay once again, we've seen this all every game. I feel like Colossus are much more viable now because of, you know, if you go mech, you just, it can be a bit nasty if you go high templates first. And you need to splash because, of course, you have to deal with, you know, the bio, which only splash can deal with once they get medivacs out. So, of course, he goes for his medivac timing himself. And this is when I was saying he's a cheater. Bullshit that he's not a cheater, man. I'm sorry for the swearing there. Look, so he sends his medivacs up, he boosts them. Watch this. Look. So he's keeping an eye on his medivacs. It's actually probably important to note. Where's... I have an observer right there. That spotted the medivacs. Just about spotted them. Alright. So I know. If I go back to his... Look at that. Oh, I missed it. I think I went a bit too far back then as well. So my... See, I just about see it, so that's cool. He boosts them up. This is just general talk now. This is for entertainment purposes. Look. Watch this. Just keep an eye on his medivacs. They're over here. Wait, this button... Oh, okay. For some reason, that button was... a bit confusing then. Look. Oh, right there. I'll go 10 seconds back. So that way we get the full vibe. So... this is his vision. So he's, you know, moving around, seeing what's going on. Goes back up to his medivacs, get ready. Ooh, do you see that? And he changes them. Now let's watch that again. Or, spot on 11 minutes. He's looking at my army. See? 100% hacker, no way. And then the best thing is, right, I knew he was hacking, you're like, once you get to a certain point in this game, you'll be able to tell a hacker based on that things. Look at this. He flies directly through everything I have, every single thing I have, and lands in my main. And I have my photon overcharge ready on my Nexus, because I know it's coming. But, like, you know. Yeah, what a hacker. Of course, my Colossus is out in pretty fast time. The overcharge runs out, so I, you know, it was a bit early, but I expected the drop a lot faster. It kills quite a nice little handful of harvesters. And I warp in some stalkers right here to finish this off, because this guy deserves it. And yeah, we're back to even. He takes the third base, but of course this is a hacker, so it's hard to say. In the end, I eventually beat him. Because he does things like this a couple times, and you can, like... if you ever play a map hacker in, like, Call of Duty or Counter-Strike, you can predict... or you can abuse it, because you know that they're going to try and pre-fire you around shots, so you stand close to, like, the wall, and then you pop out really fast. My proxy pylon allows me to harass him, and, you know, I shut down his army. And yeah, sorry to talk about that guy cheating, but, like, yeah, what an asshole. So there we are, guys. Hopefully you all... learned a little bit, especially about the build. Like I said, you only want to do it on Cloud Kingdom, Howland Peak, Newkirk City, Corehold City, and Star Station. And like, I will put the build order roughly up to 34 supply, and then the add-ons after that, like Warp Gate, your robo, and your sentry. So there we are, guys. I hope you all enjoyed. Any questions, anything like that, please comment. You know, message me, I don't care. If there's anything, I will answer it for you, no problem. So there we are. Take care, guys, and.